some people look at China and they say, there's been no Google formed in China. There's been no Facebook developed in China. No Microsoft developed in China. And that says something about their educational system.
Partly the educational system, but partly because there's a very tight control at the top. They do not like the established order to be tinkered with. If it's working fine, leave it. And if anybody has something good, we'll borrow it and test it out. Why take the risk? Their attitude is, let's play it safe. If you let 1.3 billion smart guys experimenting, you'll have near chaos. And they're capable of thinking up new things. I'll give you an example. I go on the computer for translations now into Chinese and vice versa.
Yes.
And it's all done free. The Chinese have done it. It's called N-Siku.
Yes. N-Siku.
Siku is a reservoir, Siku. And you can do wonders with it. And there are many such things. You can, anything you want to do on the internet, there's no need to go to Google, you can go to Baidu and
yeah,
do
Baidu
the same.
Is a Chinese search engine.
Yeah.
The large one too, they own 60-70% of the Chinese market.
That's right.
What did you think of what the Chinese did to Google?
Well, they didn't want Google to become a vehicle for subversion, what they called subversion, the spreading of ideas inimical to the stability of the state.
Do you think they're too paranoid?
Chinese fear of any government is luan, means chaos.
Yes.
It's a huge country, and you cannot control everything. You cannot micro-control it, so you just say, stop it.
Join us online at charlierose.com.